From De La Salle High School in Concord, it's the Comcast Game of the Week. Hello, everybody. I'm Anthony Schultz. Championship soccer coming to you tonight. Two teams both on a roll, coming in 9 wins for both these teams. And tonight, joining me in the booth will be head coach of Clayton Valley, Chris Kaleo. And, Coach, we should have a great game on tap for tonight.
Yes, I'm expecting a lot of fast action on the field. The defenses are very tough, and even though both teams are offensively minded, it's going to be a tough defensive struggle.
Yeah, a couple of players to watch, both goalkeepers. First, B.J. Burns has had an excellent year, and he's really been tough to score on.
Yeah, B.J. has been very tough. The defense has helped him record 13 shutouts this season, and he's very stingy in goals, allowing only 10 goals all the year.
And for De La Salle, of course, the former Swiss national team member, Stefan Frey, also has had a great year in goal for the Spartans.
Yeah, even though his name is Stefan, everybody at De La Salle calls him Swiss. He's very tough as well. He's given up only 11 goals and 17 shutouts. So look for a defensive struggle today.
Should be a great game. Championship soccer on the line. This one is for all the marbles. Stay tuned. The Game of the Week is coming up next.
For decades, Dolan's has been providing... performance. Maximize your potential. We guarantee it.
And welcome to Championship Soccer right here on Comcast. It's the Mustangs of Monte Vista versus the Spartans of De La Salle, a rematch of this very championship game 2 years ago, a game that De La Salle won. So Monte Vista looking for a little payback. And Coach Kaleo up here with me in the booth. This should be a great game here tonight.
Yeah, I expect it to be a great game.
Coach, we talked about the goalkeepers earlier. Any other players that would stand out here tonight? A couple of guys maybe that you think that could have big games?
Yeah, big games would be Patrick Dolan, good midfielder for De La Salle, top scorer for their team. And defensively, Nick Seithel, the center of their backs. And for Monte Vista, they have tough defenders, fast sweeper, and Spencer Lewis. And a top goal scorer for the team, Barrett Park.
So certainly some good players here tonight. And, Of course, when you have a championship game, obviously there's got to be some good players or these teams wouldn't be in the position that they're in. We should have a great game here tonight.
Yeah, it's a championship game, and both teams are so good that there's not going to be any losers tonight. They're all winners for playing here and making it to this final game. And I just look to see some fast action on the field. Some good one-touch soccer and strong defensive formations.
Well, Monte Vista arrived here. They won 3 playoff games. They beat Mission of San Jose 2-1. Likewise against Richmond 2-1, and they defeated San Ramon in the semifinal 1-0 to arrive at this championship game. And a first-round bye for De La Salle. They beat Cal 1-0, and then we had the game against Amador just the other night 3-0. And Coach, in that game, only a 3-0 score, but really domination by, I thought, from my point perspective, domination by De La Salle. How do they change that around if you're Monta Vista?
De La Salle definitely put a lot of pressure on Amador Valley, and they should have had a few more goals. But it was something that Monta Vista will have to do is make sure they have a strong defense to not give up that many opportunities as Amador Valley did, and then look for taking advantage of their speed and working the field, not so much north and south, but east and west, so that keeps that defense moving on the De La Salle side. That will hopefully open up some more scoring opportunities for Monta Vista.
Hopefully, because Amador really, they had maybe, I think, two realistic shots on goals, and I think even one of those wasn't really a power shot, didn't look like one that was even going to get through. Getting set here for the opening kickoff and the start of today's championship ball game right here from Owen Owens Field in Concord and De La Salle High School. Just got word, Coach, that the Monta Vista girls have claimed the NCS championship. They won in overtime is what I'm hearing.
Wow, wouldn't that be something if both Monta Vista teams win the boys and girls 3A championships this year?
Now here we're underway. Ball being kicked around toward the middle of the field. And yeah, a lot of heading going on here so far.
And there's the first foul. Players just bumping each other right off the spot. They're a little nervous as the ball's up in the air. They'll calm down pretty soon and get it on the floor.
Now, I didn't see a whole lot of contact, Coach. And that goes up to referee's discretion, right? Here's a ball near the goal. And a save. First save of the ball game, and that was very, very close.
Yeah, you can tell it's a little jittery yet. The ball's playing up in the air.
Take a look at the replay there.
Wow, the De La Salle defense just was letting that ball roll around dangerously in front of goal. It could have been a key opportunity for Monta Vista to score.
And I'll tell you, Coach, you know, no offense to Amador Valley, but that was closer than they got scoring the whole night in that last game that we did. So a positive sign for Monta Vista.
Yeah, it's very important that both teams establish dominance in the first 5-10 minutes of the game. It can change the whole outcome of the game if they're just putting the other players on their heels. And that's what you want to do is show your dominance in the beginning of the game and get the other people thinking that they're in for a tough game tonight.
Here's a throw-in.
Great throw-in into the...
That's Zahner, who's just wonderful at that, has really accounted for a lot of the scoring for this Monta Vista team just by those throw-ins. And you saw the good arms that he had, but De La Salle able to thwart the attempted goal there for Monta Vista. Here's one off the chest.
You know, it's amazing.
Sideline.
When teams are this good, it's the set plays that makes the difference. And it's going to be key, especially if they continue to throw the ball in the front of the goal and create havoc. That's going to be tough on the defense and the goalkeeper.
Monta Vista on the far sideline trying to keep it in. And now De La Salle will play it back to the goalkeeper and boot this one out of trouble.
That's a good clearance by Stefan. He's got a great foot. Now this, that was his left foot, and he still made it out near the midfield line.
On his way to California to play soccer at the next level. And one of those guys, you never know, Coach, we might see him playing professional soccer sometime down the road.
Yes, he's a very strong player. You know, for a goalkeeper, he has great foot skills as well, and that's very key. The defense has tremendous confidence in passing the ball back to him.
Here's Monta Vista on the attack.
You know, that's something that Monta Vista is going to be looking for, is that quick switch of the field, because De La Salle's defense, they look and rotate to the strong side of the ball, leaving the backside open. So look for a lot of crossing passes by Monta Vista tonight. Setting up for a long throw-in. Notice how everybody's in the penalty area.
There's another throw in on the side. De La Salle heads this one back out. Mustangs trying to keep it in near the goal, and the Mustangs threatening here early.
Look at the pressure they're putting on that De La Salle defense.
And De La Salle able to clear back to midfield, but here's Monta Vista keeping it back in.
Nice control by Monta Vista there as they swing the ball around the opposite side of the field. Notice the one-touch passing. It's looking good so far.
And down the far sideline. They battled for it there.
The success for Monta Vista is their ability to take advantage of the open outside lanes of the field, because that's where De La Salle will let you play out there. They'll protect that center.
You know, the early returns have some positive signs here for Monta Vista. They're able to keep the ball in their offensive end, and De La Salle boots it back the other way, something that De La Salle was able to have the advantage the other way in that last game against Amador. Yes, and this one is booted out of bounds.
It looks good for Monta Vista so far. They just got to keep under control, keep their shape, and keep the pressure on De La Salle.
Well, Dolan scored a goal for De La Salle in that last game. And then Devin Perez had a pair of goals in that 3-0 win over Amador. Certainly a game that he will remember.
Yeah, Devin has showed up big in the last part of the season. Oh, there's a shot just over.
He's been booted over the crossbar and out of bounds.
But Devin's been hot lately for De La Salle, scoring quite a few goals in their matches.
Yeah, coming into tonight's game with 26 points as we take a look at the replay. And here's a ball by the Spartans, booted over the crossbar, and there it is.
Yeah, notice that the Monta Vista defense did not get away with it that much and left an opportunity for De La Salle to get a strike on goal.
Here's B.J. Burns booting this one toward midfield. And the Heads wait for it. And De La Salle the first one to get a noggin on it.
Patrick Dolan is one of the strongest players in the league that I've seen on head balls. You'll watch on all the throw-ins, they'll look to play it to him, and he'll look either to flick it on to the other side to open up a shot for their teammates. So watch during this game. He'll play a lot of head balls to Patrick Dolan.
And Burns with the drop kick, and this one is a scorcher.
Yeah, it looks like we're going to have a punting contest between Stefan and BJ tonight.
Here's De La Salle trying to get it back in the offensive end, but it's Monta Vista with the upper hand.
Yeah, look at Monta Vista. Nice pass. Trying to get it over the top. There's the control. He's going to try to go the other side, and there's a clearance by Patrick Dolan.
Jeff Briz had it momentarily, and now we're going to have a foul.
It was over the back on him, and you can't do that in this game. Referee will catch it every time.
Referee's in blue tonight. Take a look at the replay.
Yeah, look at. See, he had his knee definitely in his back, and the referee caught it. So he's going to keep the game under control.
Danny Daughton over the back there for Monta Vista. And now the free kick upcoming here for Stefan Fry, who's come way out of goal.
Yeah, this is a common practice by De La Salle. They know that he can put that ball in a penalty area where it's very dangerous. Well, De La Salle is going to try to crash that area and create havoc.
There's one booted down.
Great ball. There's Patrick. There, he just missed. And there's
De La Salle just wide left. So you're talking about that great leg by Fry. It certainly came in there. And it looked like Fitzpatrick, I believe, number four, had a goal-scoring opportunity. His shot is just wide left. So really, the Mustangs dodge a bullet there.
There's the ball. Looking for Patrick Fry. He was looking to flick it on, and here's the backside. Oh, Fitzpatrick just missed it.
Very close play for De La Salle. Nearly had the 1-0 lead. This one headed backwards.
There's Evan Armstrong. He's building up from the back. There's a play on. He's looking to change it.
Boy, five red shirts running down to the offensive end. Now we have a stoppage of play here.
It looks like there was a foul behind the play on that one. The referee saw a foul on Evan Armstrong, but he had a play on advantage. But something happened behind the ball there, and that's what caused the play to come back. And here comes Swiss again.
Here he comes. Another big boot upcoming. And you mentioned Evan Armstrong. Another guy that will likely be playing at the next level. So far, Davis and Chico, I understand, are showing interest in his services.
That's right.
This one more of a line drive off the ground here.
And there's Evan trying to clear it. And Andrew Ross sending it in. But no problem for BJ. He
and
goes
BJ
up
in that goal box, able to collect it. And he'll boot it away.
Boy, these kicks really spread out the field.
This one is absolutely launched, headed toward the near side of the field.
That's
here
Michael
the Spartans
Madden
trying to keep it. Fitzpatrick, ball knocked away.
There's Devin Perez. Over
there's
there.
Perez wreaking some havoc, and now this one booted down.
There's a good attempt by Patrick to put it in the corner, but a little bit too much on that pass.
There's BJ, and not enough white shirts down there to make that one count.
Now, you'll find that De La Salle is going to try to open the field by sending those long balls, and they'll look for the opportunity coming down the wings. Nick Fitzpatrick just wasn't ready for that one.
Here's BJ booting this one a long way. A couple of red shirts in the vicinity here. And this one is headed out of bounds.
That was Nick Seithel going up there. Now here we go. It looks like Zahner's out there again. Another big throw. There goes De La Salle dropping back to the penalty area. And Monta Vista sending all their boys there.
And again, here's that throw-in situation. Monta Vista's had a real advantage over this.
And Swiss anticipated that very nicely.
He just comes in and makes the catch.
He wasn't even staying on his goal line on that one. He came out to the penalty area and was looking for that all the way.
And he boots this one back the other way.
And Monta Vista have no problem clearing that one. But now De La Salle gathers up. Patrick Fry plays it back nicely. They'll get it under control here.
Chris Bevel for the Mustangs had it momentarily, couldn't control.
They're swinging it around to Scytham. He'll go out there to Harkins.
And
long ball
out
to Perez. He couldn't get it, though.
Trying to kick it down, and now the Spartans on the attack. A lot of red shirts there. Bodies collide.
A little bit of contact, but really nothing dangerous. It didn't look like he was going to get that ball anyway.
Look at the Mustangs nearly lost that one, and here's De La Salle back on the attack.
There's Talibas coming up from his defense. There's a shot.
There's a shot on goal, but right to BJ, and he handles that one fairly easily. But again, at least De La Salle, we're starting to see their offense come together a little bit.
Yeah, that was a nice build-up. There's a couple quick passes into the center, and Nick just couldn't get enough on it.
Take a look at the replay there.
Yeah, it looked like the kick just ricocheted off his other foot a little bit, and that made it easy for BJ to get it.
Harkins headed that ball out of bounds, so another throw-in upcoming here.
Yep. Zayn the special.
Rocco's Ristorante and Pizzeria voted best pizza in the East Bay, Ignacio Valley Road at Oak Grove. And Velocity Sports Performance, 1505 Willow Pass Road in Concord, 363-0066.
And there we go. De La Salle is getting out of trouble again.
There's Fitzpatrick trying to run it down.
There's Evan Armstrong controlling it.
Armstrong with it.
Trying to send a ball to the opposite side of the field. He's got number 11, Barrett Park, one of their leading scorers.
Barrett Park, usually a midfielder. He's actually been playing more on defense, and he's the kind of guy that can really utilize his speed to sort of counteract that speed of De La Salle, and a guy that's off to Wake Forest after this. So another one of these players that will be playing at the next level. Ball booted out of bounds, and it'll be a throw-in upcoming here for the Mustangs. Dolan's Lumber, Doors and Windows, 2750 Camino Diablo in Walnut Creek, 2231 Monument Boulevard in Concord.
There's that long throw again.
Brentwood Dodge, Chrysler, and Jeep. And this one goes right back to Swiss, and another easy chance for him. You almost want to give him a save on that, but that was a little too easy.
Yeah, that was. I mean, there's not too much pressure.
Brentwood Dodge, Chrysler, and Jeep, 8085 Brentwood Boulevard in Brentwood, 634-9900. Thanks to all of our sponsors helping us to bring to you the Comcast Game of the Week. Here's one by De La Salle, booted up and out of bounds.
That was nice anticipation by Sean Talibas there to stop the attack and clear it upfield.
Now, Coach, a player that you know a lot about, Sean Talibas, you once coached him.
Yeah.
What kind of player is he?
Sean has really grown since I've coached him, but he's tough, and as you'll see tonight, he'll be doing all the long throw-ins. And as you saw before, he came up on the attack and made it dangerous in that area.
But you laid the foundation for his progress.
Oh, maybe very little.
Here's one being booted around. Fitzpatrick giving chase. And the Mustangs able to get that out of bounds.
Yeah, that's where De La Salle's speed. Quick counter. Tried to take advantage of open areas, but...
Yeah, you saw four red shirts down there, but nearly a situation where De La Salle had a breakaway there.
Yeah, it's very important at the defense, if there's that many players, that they communicate and make a commitment to clear that ball.
You know, the Spartans trying to keep it back in. Ball being chased down by Travis Livingston. Now out to BJ. And this one kicked to the sideline. Here's a throw-in upcoming.
Yeah, BJ has pretty good feet skills as well, but he's playing off his weaker foot there, the left foot, and he was just looking to clear to get out of danger as De La Salle put pressure on him.
Here's the Spartans, and this one is knocked out of bounds by Monta Vista and Barrett Park.
And there's the Leavis over to Dolan.
Here's Patrick
nice
Dolan.
Nice switch to Alec Harkins.
Across the field, far side.
Setting it down the line. There's that speed we're talking about. There's a good cross, but Montevis is there to take it.
The Spartans trying to get that one centered that time, but a lot of red shirts in the vicinity.
Right.
But they're going to have a throw in here anyhow for the Spartans. So at least momentarily, Coach, they'll keep it down on the offensive end. Big crowd here tonight, Saturday evening from Concord. Slight chill in the air, but certainly not as cold as it was the other night.
No,
and
but it's
a couple of times through, Coach, last couple of games, we've had some pretty good crowds out here.
Yeah, well, you know, it's the end of the season. A lot of people want to see good soccer, and they'll definitely see tonight.
There's a big wide swing right there for De La Salle. Ball comes out. Here's Monta Vista storming back the other way.
And there goes
Barrett Park with it. And then he and Dolan collide, and we're going to have a foul call.
The referee thought it was too tough, and it looks like he'll get a yellow.
Now explain this foul here, Coach. Why is there a foul here?
Oh, he came in a little bit reckless. He's just swinging away. Dangerous play when you see that foot go that high.
Yeah, on the replay, it really looked much more like a foul than it did in live action.
Yeah, slowing it down for us really helps.
Here's Jeff Briz now. He'll have a free kick. I want to say from the 38, but I know that doesn't really matter. We'll just say on the Spartan side of the field.
Yeah, that's a safe way to communicate. You know, those numbers down there really make it confusing for us in the booth. Josh Schuller came in to replace Patrick Dole in the middle, and that could be a little loss for De La Salle. Let's see how long they keep him out.
Here's Briz kicking it down, headed back out by De La Salle. And the Mustangs
and
try to keep it in the zone.
It looks like Montevista is owning the midfield right now. And there's that nice moving the ball back and forth, trying to create space there.
This ball on the far side.
Let's try to get it down on the ground, boys.
Ball remains up in the air. A couple of players going for it that time.
And that was Josh clearing it out there.
And this one kicked out of bounds by De La Salle, and a throw-in upcoming here for Montevista. Brian Voltatorni, head coach at De La Salle, giving instructions to one of his players. Another ball headed out of bounds.
Yeah, he's talking to Patrick Dolan, letting him know now that probably you're going to go back in the game soon, and let's make sure we stay under control because he's an important player for them. We want to keep him in the rest of the game.
Now, did Dolan receive a yellow card or anything that time? I didn't see the coach put anything up.
Yeah, he did receive a yellow card. That's the only reason why he's sitting out. He's definitely not
tired.
So he's
got to be very careful then.
Yeah, he's going to have to watch it, but he's a disciplined player.
Here's one booted.
That was Evan Armstrong trying to send it in, but not a dangerous play. Looks like we must have a really big crowd now because it looks like they're opening up the other stands for overflow.
Purchase your copy of this game, shipping courtesy of UPS included, $25. Give us a call, 933-6264. Still no score here. About 17 minutes into the contest. NCS championship on the line here tonight. A rematch of the 0-3 championship game, which De La Salle won, so Montevista looking for a little payback. And Montevista, having had the girls already claim the NCS championship, the boys trying to make it a clean sweep for the varsity teams.
I think it was Barrett Parks down the line. Again, they're looking to open up the outside, and that's a goal kick.
It looks like from that side, Coach, they're trying to get the ball centered right there, but De La Salle is able to prevent them from doing so.
Yeah, that's a key for Montevista. You'll notice that was Nick Seithel that came from a central defensive area to get out on the outside. And if Montevista can open up the middle, that's going to be dangerous.
All right, here comes Swiss. We're going to see some more of that long leg.
And there it is. Devin Perez. Oh.
Headed backwards very nicely that time.
Yeah, Devin headed that up to Fitzpatrick and just missed going through.
And out of bounds on the far side.
No, that's not Fred Wilson.
No.
So a throw-in upcoming here for the Spartans.
There's Sean Tolivas again. There's that big throw.
Here's Sean, has this one headed back out.
Oh,
goes
and there's a
the
shot.
Goal and wide right.
That was a dangerous shot by Josh Twilliger.
And another look at that big crowd on hand. In a very festive mood.
Yeah, they got all their signs out today.
Got the banners out and everything. And here comes BJ in. And so far, both goalkeepers have been featured very prominently with their long kicks. Anthony Schultz, or Tony Schultz as they're writing on the screen, along with Chris Kaleo, coming to you from Owen Owens Field in Concord. This one's sent toward the midfield.
That was Mike Madden that went up and got that hit.
Fitzpatrick got a leg on it. Here's Montevista.
Nice one touch. Armstrong to Barrett Parks.
Barrett
there's
Park.
And back to Evan Armstrong.
And this one's going to be chased down.
He got a little aggressive there.
But another fairly good chance there for Montevista, not able to come up with that shot on goal. But still, they're doing a pretty good job in keeping the ball down in the offensive end a lot more often than I'm sure many teams have been able to do against this good De La Salle squad.
Yeah, there it goes. The key to that was a quick 1-2 passing that creates the opening. It doesn't let the De La Salle defense set up, and Evan Armstrong made a great run there.
And here comes Fry with another big boot. Everybody waits for it. Now coming out to the near side. Ball knocked out of bounds. Throw in for the Spartans. A lot of red shirts around. And here come the Mustangs trying to get it out of their end. And now out of bounds, and the Mustangs will control.
Yeah, Sean Tlaib was a little aggressive there, and the referee called him for a foul. It looks like whenever Patrick Dolan's going up for the head ball, they got Tyler Westfall on the Monta Vista defense. He's like 6'4", so he's going to be a big battle there.
Here's one booted down. Let's see if Monta Vista can't get another good chance out of this.
That was a clear by Josh Twilliger. There's nice a long ball up to Devin there. Perez. Here's a quick
Perez.
Counter.
It's Patrick with him. And Monta Vista able to thwart that opportunity. But you can see how quickly De La Salle can get it from one end of the field to the other and get an offensive chance.
Yeah, and that's going to be key.
Tell us what you think. We want to hear from you. Give us a call, 933-6264, and tell us what you think about the Comcast Game of the Week.
Yeah, what you're going to see is if Monta Vista keeps attacking, let's watch this throw in here. There's Patrick Dolan going for it, and there's a clear.
This one booted away by Monta Vista, and then headed back the other way, and this one will go out of bounds, and a throw-in upcoming for the Mustangs.
But what I was saying is if Monta Vista sees their success being offensively, sometimes you get the defenders to push up too much, and that's when the quick counter by De La Salle will make it dangerous, as that last play showed.
Ticking down under 19 minutes to go here in the first half. Still no score. Both teams have had an assorted amount of chances so far. Nobody's been able to put the ball in the net as of yet. And now Stephon Fry.
That was ahead by Mike Madden, but nobody really went in for the challenge. B.J. gobbled it up quite nicely.
And B.J. will punt it back the other way with a drop kick. We're going to call over the back that time, or just out of bounds? Take another look
again
here.
On that replay, it was a nice flick on, but I think the Monta Vista defense was ready for that, and B.J. had all day to get it.
Yeah, neither goalie has had to make the great save as of yet. Defense keeping both offenses, for the most part, in check.
There's
headed forward.
That was Tyler Westfall. He's tall, but he used his arms that time to push the player and was called for the foul, so De La Salle get the kick.
And again, here's Stephon Fry. And he'll put a leg into this one.
It's always good when you can have 11 players help you on offense. When he sends those balls that long, that's more like a field player. And there was Tyler Westwell going up for the head ball.
This ball kicked back
toward
midfield.
Vincent Culvis there. Play a little bit aggressive. Call for the foul.
And we have a foul. And Monta Vista will get the free kick.
You know, so far it looks pretty even so far, and nobody's making any mistakes. They're very careful on that, which is very good.
And another time for BJ. Into a big crowd, headed back toward midfield. Mustangs able to keep it in the offensive end here.
That was Nick Seithel heading over to Patrick Dolan. Outside to Harkins and out the field to Vincent Culvis. He can't get it. Westfall's got it and sends it up the field out of bounds. Oh, it looks like it went off somebody's foot there from De La Salle.
So that means another throw-in upcoming here for Monta Vista.
And there's their specialist, Adam Zahner. Looking for a target player, number 15, Westfall.
See if he can't get this one in the middle of the pack and give
there
the team a
chance. There it is, and he looked to flick it on to change it in the back door.
There's one booted toward the near side.
That's Josh Twilliger clearing it out. That's Barrett Parks with the ball. Ooh, got the pass through.
This one booted out toward midfield again. So another would-be opportunity for Monta Vista goes awry. See if they can't claim another chance. Now Now it's Spartan.
There's Dolan dribbling around. There's Terwilliger.
Nice footwork there by Dolan, avoiding a couple of players.
And there goes Nick Scytha from his defensive area. Played up to Barrett Parks by Monta Vista. Oh, and he just flicked it out of bounds, just a little too much.
Some fancy footwork there by Barrett, trying to kick the ball to himself and keep that dribble. But it goes out of bounds, and De La Salle will toss it in.
It looks like De La Salle is really respecting Monta Vista's attack, as they're not trying to pass the ball around the back. They're looking to clear it away quickly out of danger. We're already 25 minutes just about into the game. No score here. There's Vincent Kolbas. Looks like a foul over the back.
Foul against Monta Vista. So De La Salle will control. And here comes Stephon Fry to give this some more leg here as the players collect down in the Monta Vista end of the field.
Let's see if he can get it deeper in the box. The last two have been line drives. There's a good kick. And there's Talibas. Got his foot on it.
That goes wide right and a little bit high. The other shot not on goal that time. But De La Salle did get the ball down there in pretty good shape again that time.
On this replay, VJ from his position, he sees the ball coming in. And you notice as Sean Talibas, he gathers it in. He makes a turn, but he just did not get enough onto it and shot it over and wide of the goal.
Went off the outside part of his foot. Not able to turn that one as goalward that time. He went out toward midfield.
Michael Madden was called for foul for an elbow. The referee's playing it tight tonight.
Seems like he was a little frustrated with that call, the referee giving him an explanation. But a free kick upcoming here for Spencer Lewis.
Spencer Lewis is one of their fast defenders for Monta Vista. He plays a sweeper position. He's the guy that's going to save you in the end.
Here goes Fitzpatrick.
He sends it up wide, and there's Lewis' speed closing in on him.
Too many red shirts that time. Fitzpatrick trying to keep it, waiting for some help, and now he gets it.
Alex Alizar sends it in the middle for Kolbas.
Headed away. Dolan whacks this one with the left foot, but not close to the goal, and out of bounds it goes. But another big kick up coming here for BJ.
But that's the important thing for De La Salle to keep shooting. You know, sometimes.
Rocco's Ristorante and Pizzeria, voted best pizza in the East Bay. Ignacio Valley Road at Oak Grove. And thanks very much for the crew meal tonight, guys. Pizza, as always, delicious. Velocity Sports Performance, Willow Pass Road in Concord, 363-0066.
You know, it's very important that De La Salle continues to take shots on goal, because that's going to open up the defense. Exactly what you want to do in the game. That's Vincent Kolbas. He headed it wide. But it looks like
wide,
he's
they give chase. And another throw-in upcoming.
Danny Dotton plays it back. Looks to Spencer Lewis. And they're going to swing the ball around there. He's holding on to too long. Gives the De La Salle defense a chance to set up. But it looks like he got it out to Evan Armstrong. Armstrong's looking wide here. He sends a good ball down the line there.
Here's their chance.
Oh, and there's a good shot.
And thwarted.
Oh.
And this one off the side of the goal.
That was a great, great play by Armstrong, sending the Moriarty down the left side there.
Another good chance. Probably one of the best chances that Monta Vista has had. And you can hear the crowd getting all fired up when that ball gets close to the goal. But the Spartans, fortunate, they play good defense that time. Yep. And again, the Monta Vista offense frustrated.
You notice he made the initial shot, and Stephon had to adjust, and he got the rebound, but he put it on the side of the net instead of in the net. But a good scoring opportunity for Monta Vista today.
And they've had a few there tonight, so they've been able to keep the ball on the offensive end.
And there's that big clear I was talking about. They're not going to let that ball back there at all. De La Salle defense. There's Michael Madden heading up to Kolbas, and he tries to one touch it down the line, but a little bit too hard.
And knocked out of bounds that time by Kolbas, and a throw-in upcoming here for Monta Vista.
There's Danny Dalton. He went up for the ball, and Parks brings it down very nicely. De La Salle tried to switch it there, but Monta Vista clearly closing down the gap in the midfield.
Here's one kick toward the De La Salle end, but an easy chance here for Stephon Fry.
Yeah, Stefan called his defense off there, let him know that he was going to get it, and that's a good opportunity of communication there. So he can send his long kick here. There's Tyler Westfall again. He's a tall guy, 6'4". He clearly got that one quite easily. They're going to have to keep the ball away from him if they want to be successful.
And booted out of bounds. A throw-in upcoming for the Spartans from the far side of the field.
It looks like they're going to give Sean Tolivas a break there. It's not too deep in their zone, so they're going to keep Sean here and let Alex Harkins take the throw-in.
Alex tossing it in and then booted back out of bounds. So
yeah, that's
same situation, but now a chance for Monta Vista.
That's a tweener throw. You want to get it to his feet or to his head, but not in between. It's too hard to handle, especially if you have a defender on your back. That was Andrew Roth trying to go through the Monta Vista defense, but they cleared the ball nicely.
Now talk about how good these two teams have been this year. 13 shutouts recorded for Fred Wilson and his Mustangs. 17 shutouts for Brian Voltatorne. And here's a near chance for De La Salle.
Oh, there was a long ball. Devin Perez got it behind the Monta Vista defense there. And De La Salle's earned their first corner kick. Let's see what they do on this set play.
Well, to see if they can't get this one centered to give them a chance to score.
This is where De La Salle excels on set plays. They're going to try to go near post, or they're going to try to cross the back. Let's see what they do the first time.
Here's that corner kick, trying to head it, and this one's headed away by Monta Vista.
Yeah, they tried to go in the back post. They did have the opening, but nobody was there. Oh, there's a great ball. Perez
kicks, and this one is going to be wide.
Well, I think that
Perez had a good chance that time as Monta Vista had trouble clearing the ball.
And there's another corner kick.
And it's going to be out of bounds. And now another corner kick upcoming here for De La Salle.
Here's the replay. Devin Perez did get behind the defense. He was going to shoot, but the Monta Vista player came in at the last moment to put it away. But it's a good corner kick situation here. They go deep again too hard.
A little too far that time. De La Salle's not able to get that one in the middle and hopefully to get somebody to get ahead on that ball. And here's Monta Vista racing the other way down the far side of the field.
Yeah, that's Evan Armstrong. He's got speed. Look at that long ball over the top, but Nick Seifel cleared it. That's Jeff Britz, and he takes
Britz,
a shot.
And his shot.
Swiss got it.
Caught by Swiss. So end-to-end action here. Ball getting from one side of the field to the other very quickly.
And
Swiss boots this one a long way.
That's where their speed comes in. Andrew
and
Roth.
Here's a tackle right here.
And we're going to see a yellow here. That's number 14 for Monta Vista, Travis Livingston. He just went in too tough. He's going to get called.
So he's going to come out and take another look at it here. A lot of contact. There it is.
Yeah, he just went for the foot. Andrew was going to beat him. He knew he was beat, so it's a safe place to make a foul, but it earned him a yellow.
Andrew Roth, there he is, upended that time, hit the ground hard, but appears to be all right. And now a free kick upcoming from the Monta Vista side of the field here for De La Salle. So the Spartans have had some good chances here lately.
That's Nick Seithel putting it in dangerously.
And DJ making the catch, backing up toward the goal.
That was almost a shot on goal, but I think he's trying to play in the dangerous area.
And Monta Vista, the near side, and this one goes out of bounds.
That was Barrett Parks. He's trying to keep the ball in, but it's a narrow field, and he just didn't have space.
Now, Coach, you were talking earlier about the narrow field being somewhat of a home field advantage for the Spartans. And what exactly did you mean by that?
Well, because they have speed and they keep their shape, they rotate their defense, and they can do that on this small field because if you're going to send the ball the opposite side long-wise, they're going to have time to get there because it's not 70, 75 yards. It's only about 60 yards wide.
Devin Perez giving chase to this one, trying to keep it in the offensive end.
There's Mike Madden. He's going to gather in. He's going to look to change it to Patrick Dolan. Dolan brings it down nicely, but he was pressured. But Madden saves it on the end. Yeah, it's kicked out by Monta Vista. Sean Tolivas is going to come up and take that long throw in.
So here comes Tolivas. Dolan's Lumber, Doors and Windows, 2750 Camino Diablo in Walnut Creek, 2231 Monument Boulevard in Concord.
There's a throw in. And
this one's headed away, and out of bounds will be a corner kick upcoming here.
You know, that's the third corner kick for De La Salle so far. Monta Vista doesn't have any, so you know that they're putting pressure on.
Brentwood Dodge Chrysler and Jeep, 8085 Brentwood Boulevard in Brentwood, 634-9900. Here's that corner kick, and it could. Somebody got a head on that for Monta Vista.
Yeah, that was a better deliverance for De La Salle, but notice trying to quick counter Monta Vista.
Here's Monta Vista trying to change it, and here's a nice steal.
There it is.
Near midfield.
There is number six, Moriarty, and then he looks to change it again. There goes Trevor.
Down the far side of the field for the Mustangs. See if they can't keep it in, but some fancy footwork that time, Coach.
Yep.
By both teams.
And that's what Monta Vista is looking to do. Notice they were going east-west on that, and then they went north-south. So keeping the defense shifting to both sides of the field, that's going to be the key. And there's a foul on Alec Harkins, it looks like.
So De La Salle now with seven fouls on this game. It'll be a free kick situation on the De La Salle side of the field for Monta Vista.
And again, let's look and see if they play for Tyler Westfall, their tall player there.
There's one kick.
No, they went deep.
Headed the other way.
Evan Armstrong
pumping it back in, but that's an easy catch for Swiss. And now he'll boot it back out.
I guess we can say that was a generous shot, an easy save for Swiss.
Neither goaltender so far has been really challenged. It's a credit to each defense.
Yeah, you know, it's more than just a goalkeeper out there, and the defenses are playing tough.
They really are. Even though the offenses are getting the ball close, they're still not getting those really good, solid shots on goal.
No, both defenses are closing down quickly, and just when you think they're getting an awful clear shot, somebody's coming in deflecting it. There's Evan Armstrong. He's gathering it in. Looks to play it wide. Oh, there's a turnover. Salazar, he's a fast player. And then to Perez.
They played right near there. That one, but the ball goes out of bounds.
There's another yellow. Can't see who the player that was, but
looked like it was number four, Spencer Lewis.
Yeah, he just
take another look here.
Again, it looks like Salazar was going to get by Lewis, and he just had to do the best he can do and stop him.
Spencer Lewis going to come out of the game here.
And that could be key because he's their speedy defender in the back. He's the one that is the last man.
He'll be able to come back in the next stoppage. He is replaced momentarily. Free kick upcoming here for De La Salle.
Mike Madden takes it into the penalty area, but Tyler Westbrook clears it. Evan Armstrong heads it out.
See if this one booted well wide and high of the goal and out of bounds. And now BJ will have a chance to kick this one out of trouble for Monta Vista.
Yeah, De La Salle is going to try to keep taking those long shots so that the defense is going to have to come out and play them. And that might open up some closer in shots later in the game. But that's the key is shooting the ball and opening up the defense.
Ticking down to 3:10 left in this scoreless first half. And, of course, at 2 minutes we'll get some extra time put on, but shouldn't be a whole lot of extra time, I wouldn't think.
No, I don't think so today. There hasn't been any injuries and not much stoppage. There goes Evan Armstrong. He's really running around
Armstrong
quite a bit
giving
today.
A chase and a nice turn to keep that one in possession.
Nice one-touch play there.
But
he lost
move.
It. Oh, and there's a foul. I don't know whether he was fouled on that one or he tripped over the ball as he was turning it, but there's a good opportunity for Monta Vista. Here
good
it is.
Here.
He turned with it. Maybe a slight push, but not much.
In the event, it's going to be a free kick.
And Spencer Lewis is back in it quickly
back into the game.
Barrett Park sends it into the middle. Headed out by De La Salle, now cleared by Nick Fitzpatrick coming from his forward position.
Perez giving chase, but Monta Vista will have this one.
Dalton takes it up over to Lewis. Knocked out by Andrew Roth. Good defense there.
Now Monta Vista with the throw in, and they boot it out of bounds. So De La Salle will throw it back the other way, and there's Fitzpatrick trying to get the ball down to him on the far, on the near side, and he is pumped out of bounds.
That was
the ball sent down to back to BJ, and a nice job by Spencer Lewis.
Yeah, that was a good shoulder-to-shoulder tackle. Little touch, but that's not much.
Headed back toward midfield.
Chris Carroll headed out, but Armstrong one-touched it, tried to get it up, but there's Mike Madden working hard. There's Evan Armstrong again.
Armstrong.
He's coming up.
Sprinting down the field.
Great ball to
the left.
Park.
And Park in the corner, trying to center it, and couldn't get a head on it that time. Monta Vista trying to keep it in the end.
That's Moriarty. He sends it in, but nobody's at the near post.
Easy play for Fry. But again, looked like they had centered the ball pretty well that time. And Again, had an opportunity, but nothing came of that one. And still, and now we're down to 2 minutes here. They've added some time. So nearing the end of this first half, it's Patrick. Had it taken away.
There's Madden. But again, watch. Montevista's going east-west. They're sending the ball east and west, opening up the De La Salle defense, and that's why we're seeing some scoring opportunities here tonight. That's Nick Seithel playing to Alan Harkes. Oh, buddy, it's out of bounds.
Out of bounds and a throw-in upcoming here for Montevista.
So here's Andrew Zahner again, their throw-in specialist.
And let's see if he can't give his squad a chance.
Looks like there's a substitution. Fred Wilson's trying to get another player in. Maybe not.
One of his throws was key to a win over Alameda earlier this season. A player on the ground. And they say play on. Nope, it's going to be a foul call. That'll be against Montevista this time. And here comes Swiss, and he'll have a chance to boot it away. Well, in the waning moments here of this first half.
Yeah, we're almost in the stoppage time here. According to my clock, we're over the 40-minute mark. So it should be ending pretty soon.
This one for Fitzpatrick. Now Perez heads this ball. Trying to collect it down on the near side, near the corner. And out of bounds it goes.
And that was Spencer Lewis closing in quickly on Perez and clearing it out.
Now it looks like, is Perez going to get a corner kick or just a throw-in?
It looks like it was a throw-in. Here comes Sean Talibas. So you know it's a throw-in.
Sean will toss this in. Another opportunity here for De La Salle. Trying to break the scoreless ties.
There's Dolan, flicks it on.
And this one's a goal!
Does Andrew Roth.
Andrew Roth breaks the scoreless tie. And the Talibas throw-in results in a Roth goal here. And the waning moments of this first half of the Spartans have drawn first blood. And it's De La Salle 1 and Montevista nothing.
You know, just when you think the half is going to end, De La Salle puts the pressure on. You give a long throw in to Liebes, to Andrew Roth. And here, let's watch the replay.
Take another look at it here. There's the throw in.
There's the throw in. Dolan looks like he flicks it on. Perez touches it. Nobody clears it. And Roth right through the five hole, as they say. And it's a score.
So Andrew Roth collects goal number 8. And he has 20 points overall. And De La Salle has drawn first blood, and they have forged ahead here.
You know, that could be demoralizing for Montevista, who plays so well up to that point. And it's one mistake, and how quickly a mistake can put you behind the game.
And you talk about these throw-ins, Coach, or the corner kicks near the goal, the side of the goal, when you give your team a chance to center the ball. And that usually seems to provide the best opportunities most of the time your offense.
It definitely does, and it makes the defense, they have to communicate so that everybody knows who's going to clear the ball. If there's too many people there and they don't communicate, it causes a dangerous situation like we just saw. We're in the 42 minutes of play.
So Andrew Roth breaks the scoreless tie.
And there's a quick clear by Nick Seithel. Playing back to...
This one booted down.
That's Josh Tulliger up for the head a second time. Patrick Dolan looking to clear it. And there's our halftime. With the score, De La Salle 1, Montevista 0.
So we are at halftime. We'll step aside for a break. And we'll be back to Concord. You're watching the Comcast Game of the Week.
For decades. Potential. We guarantee it.
And there's the Mount Diablo League soccer team. The youth out there getting ready. Someday they'll be maybe playing in one of these championship games.
Yeah, that's why they're out there. They're getting a feel for the field right now, and hopefully one day they'll be playing in a championship game themselves.
Well, a very tight defensive struggle there in the first half, but the Spartans able to break through with the Andrew Roth goal there in that first half.
Yeah, you know, Monta Vista was playing very well up to that point, but their defense looked not to communicate too much. They left that ball there, and Andrew Roth just came on and blasted it through the legs of V.J. Burns. A very tough play for Monta Vista, especially at the end.
Take a look at some highlights here.
Here's Monta Vista playing it wide. He flicks it in the middle again. De La Salle makes a mistake, but Stephen Fry is there.
That was probably his toughest save so far for Stephen Fry on the night.
Right, and then there's Evan Armstrong. He sends it into Moriarty. He went down the line, deflected, and then off the side of the net. Two tough plays for Monta Vista. And here's the Talivas throw-in, headed by Dolan to Devin Perez, and there's the shot by Andrew Roth. Notice, right through the legs of B.J.
Right through the wickets that time. B.J. couldn't stop that one.
And here it is again.
Their angle for this one. And there's Ross, and he knocks it through. And there's that goal, and there's a very excited De La Salle squad.
Yep.
And that's where we stand. Spartans 1, Mustangs nothing on the Comcast Game of the Week.
So for the stats, the halftime stats we have... the Mustangs, they had five shots on goal, nothing really dangerous. And their attack was good, but they didn't earn any corner kicks. They were had eight fouls. While the Spartans also had five shots, one was deadly by Andrew Roth. And it was late in the half that they started putting pressure, and that's what earned them the three corner kicks, which are dangerous set plays. And they also had eight fouls. Both teams did receive some yellows. Patrick Dolan for De La Salle. And for Monta Vista, Livingston and Lewis. So they'll have to be careful in the second half so they can play the whole game and make it nice and competitive just like the first half.
Because we did see the speed of both these teams. So a couple different times we'd see the ball at one end of the field and very quickly a scoring chance at the other end of the field.
Yeah.
Something we didn't see a lot of in that last game. But we'll take a break and be back for the start of the second half right here on Comcast.
For decades, Dolan...
Back at De La Salle High School, Owen Owens Field in Concord. Anthony Schultz along with Chris Kalea. We talked about how dominant both these teams have been and that nine in a row won by Monta Vista. You know, they won six in a row in the EBAL. They didn't give up any goals over that period. And in the three playoff games, they gave up just two goals while scoring five. And just looking at some of the overall numbers, Coach, 62-20 Monta Vista outscored opponents this year, and De La Salle likewise 59-11, so really the cream has risen to the top, and that's why these two teams are here tonight.
That's exactly right, and Monta Vista is going to need that scoring in the second half if they're going to get back in this game. And having scored 62 goals during the season, that's going to be inspiration for them to come out hard. It's going to be really important that they start the second half quick and look to open up the De La Salle defense by switching the ball just like they had, but they got to get a few more quality shots on goal.
Yeah, somehow they got to find a way to maybe get some corner kicks, get some easier chances down there. Andrew Roth scoring the only goal of the game so far, and it's a 1-0 De La Salle lead. And that one came very late in that first half after really Monta Vista showed us that they had a lot of firepower. They were moving the ball down the field, but really just a couple of quality scoring chances for Monta Vista so far, and really just a couple actually for De La Salle as well.
Yeah, but late in the half, De La Salle probably up to the first 35 minutes didn't have any corner kicks, and towards the end of the first half had three, and that shows that they were putting pressure on it. And then in extended time, the 41st minute, they scored on that long throw in deep in the area. So it's going to be exciting. I think it's going to open up for Monta Vista. They're going to have to try to come back quickly and get the score. While you're going to watch De La Salle, they're going to protect their lead, and they're going to clear the ball very quickly for this half.
Players down to the field, and as the blue-shirted referees came onto the field, a little spattering of boos greeting the officials back for the second half as we're getting set to get this second half of play underway. Spartans 1, Mustangs nothing in the NCS championship game here on Comcast.
And it's a good championship game, very evenly played. even though De La Salle's up 1-0. Both teams moving the ball quickly, and let's see what happens here in the second half. The whistle's about to blow.
All right, the teams have switched sides. Now Bonavista going from our left to our right. And De La Salle from our right to our left. And this ball kicked out of bounds.
It looks like there was a mix-up on there. And a yellow card.
A yellow card quickly here for De La Salle on this mix-up. And Coach, not exactly sure what happened there.
I don't know either. It looks... I don't know what the problem is.
So if they've confused Coach Kaleo, now I think they're going to wave that. Is that a motion to wave that yellow card off?
Yeah, it looks like they're waving it off. I think he thought maybe there was 12 guys on the field, and since he was the last guy that came on, I think they were going to give him a yellow card. But there were only 11 on the field total. I think they were just switching sides, and it confused the referee. And here's the throw-in. Zahner again.
Throwing it in.
Michael Madden controls it, leaves it on the ground. Nicely to Mikey Lawler into Devin Perez, but he couldn't handle it. And there's BJ setting it up long.
BJ booting this one back the other way.
Talibas heads it out, but West will send it into the middle, and there's Swiss. He's going to gather it in and start the counterattack here. Did a little fancy footwork there.
Now gets a little bit of pressure, then picks up the ball.
It's always nice as a keeper. You can pick it up and bring it all the way out to the 18. You don't have that luxury as a field player.
Booted high into the air.
Brought down by Jeff Fitz, but it's out of bounds for De La Salle throwing.
Little Spartans on the Mustang side to toss it in here. And of course, when you're down 1-0 in a tight defensive battle like this, things getting a little tenuous here for Monta Vista. Obviously, they can ill afford to give up that second goal.
That's for sure, because De La Salle does a great job when they have the lead. They protect it very nicely.
We talked about how many shutouts that the Spartans have put on other people, so Monta Vista certainly knows that they need to prevent any more scores here if they're going to have a chance to win this game. Ball goes out of bounds over the end line.
Yeah, De La Salle. There's the 3A national champions, Monta Vista girls.
They put it up 4-3 tonight.
Yeah, and there they are. They're wearing their trophy. They're wearing their medals.
They're wearing that championship look on their faces.
They look really happy to me. It looks like they're pointing to the boys, say, "Hey, we want another one."
All right, here's BJ to boot it away, and he does. Much shorter kick this time.
Yeah, and there's Devin Perez getting it.
Here's Fitzpatrick giving some chase over there.
Michael Lawler down, battling for the ball. There's Andrew Roth setting it up.
Right to Adam Zahner that time, able to kick it away. Players collide, no foul call there. Both just going for the ball, another head job there. Fitzpatrick out to Perez.
Keep
that
ball
in the middle of the field, and De La Salle trying to keep it in that zone. Monta Vista taken away.
Having that ball up in the air does not make it easy to play. Let's get it down on the ground, boys.
This one is going to be kicked out of bounds.
It's tough enough when you have players coming at you when the ball's on the ground. When it's up in the air, you have to bring it down and carry it, and it's very tough.
And Adam Zahner here to throw it in for Monta Vista, near side of the field.
It looks like the referee wants those players moved from the back of the goal. That's why we have a breakage in time here.
Really, something wrong with the net?
Maybe it's not all the way back on the line there.
Make sure the posts are nice and straight there.
Yeah, maybe Swiss pinched them in a little bit. Make it
referees
smaller.
Want to make sure Monta Vista has that full 24 feet of width there to work with. And here's that Monta Vista throw in.
Nice head by Nick Seithel.
Perez and then Fitzpatrick each giving it ahead.
And there's Perez putting it on the ground.
Perez, I believe he's going to be called for a foul there.
Yeah.
Knocking Evan Armstrong to the ground. Evan Armstrong, one of the captains for Monta Vista.
But it's good to see both players going very hard for the ball. So the intensity is there, just what you want to see in the game.
And now a free kick upcoming here for Monta Vista. 1-0 Spartans. This one
has a good long kick.
Booted down, headed backwards.
Back to goal.
Headed back. Looks like De La Salle was trying to head it back toward Swiss that time and nearly gave the Mustangs an opportunity, but it's going to be out of bounds. And now Zahner going to come in here with a throw-in from the near side.
Let's
so a good chance for the Mustangs here. Let's see if they can't get this one centered. There's that throw-in, headed away. Headed back in.
Cleared by Talib.
Back out toward midfield.
There's Fitzpatrick.
Fitzpatrick off and running. All by himself. Fitzpatrick going down, being chased
and
by Russian.
And there's a shot, and there's another goal.
Fitzpatrick has made it 2-0, De La Salle. And that time, Coach, when he broke away, he was all by himself. Red shirts giving chase, but they couldn't catch the quick Fitzpatrick, and it's 2-0 Spartans.
Yeah, that's the one thing, like I said, if you push your defense up too fast, you're there for the quick counterattack. That was a long ball sent by Talibas all the way up to Fitzpatrick, and he outraced him. There
Look
he is.
This. An opportunity for Monta Vista turned into an opportunity for De La Salle, and actually the redshirt caught up to him. BJ came out to defend that ball, but Fitzpatrick able to kick it by him, and there's a very happy Spartan right there.
Yeah, BJ tried to come out and close the angle, but that speed was just too much, and they placed it nicely in the net.
And, Coach, that's what I was talking about, how fast we can go from one end to the other. A scoring opportunity for Monta Vista quickly turned into a scoring opportunity and a score for De La Salle at the other end.
Yeah, that's the beauty of both these teams, their speed and quick reactions to the ball.
All right, Monta Vista trying to mount an attack. Perez kicks it back. Here's Fitzpatrick again. At least that time there was red shirts behind him.
There's a good cross down the field.
Crossed, and now we got a trip there. That'll be a foul.
No, keep he's it playing going advantage. Play on.
And now Monta Vista's got it.
Westfall up the field.
And
there's a great tackle by Talibas.
Boy, Talibas took him down, but he got the ball first that time.
Yeah, and there's another yellow card for Monta Vista. Even though the ref played on, he did the right thing and gave a yellow card to number 17, Danny Dalton.
Now, Coach, when you're sliding in like that and you make contact with the ball first and then you get that tackle, that's okay as long as it's not a dangerous situation, right?
Right. If the referees know you're playing the ball, that's the important thing. And if your cleats aren't up, then dangerous.
Take another look at it here.
There's Danny Dalton. He was going to get beat on the outside, and he just clipped the player's leg, and that's why he earned that yellow card.
So 2-0 Spartans, but still plenty of time left. Ticking down to 32 minutes to go here in the second half. But the Spartans in control here with a pair of goals, one coming from Andrew Roth late in that first half, and then Fitzpatrick added one just moments ago, and that's where we stand. A deuce for De La Salle. This one down in the Mustang offensive end and then headed out of bounds.
Yeah, there was a good ball, but all the white shirts were there, and they were headed out easy. And Andrew Zahner going up for the throw-in.
So this is the position they were in last time when they had a chance to score. De La Salle ended up scoring opportunity the other way. This one headed
There's
in.
There's Wessler, Westfield.
And then Perez going to chase it down the corner and then kick it toward midfield. Given chase there by Armstrong. Booted in and then booted away by De La Salle. Out of bounds it comes. And another throw-in here.
Notice De La Salle's commitment to defense. That was Devin Perez, their forward. He was all the way back by the touchline, clearing that ball out.
Here's a kick down to the far corner.
That was a great cross to Moriarty. Dangerous really situation.
Talib was doing a nice job to make sure that Monta Vista didn't have a good chance that time.
Yeah, Talib was closed in quickly on the defense, helping his defender and avoiding a serious situation there.
Throwing here for De La Salle. This one headed upwards. Down the far side. And this one booted off the tree and into the stands.
That was a nice save by the tree. Else it would have been out on Tree Boulevard.
Take a look at some of the fans in attendance here tonight. And the section right in under us here, Coach, filled up very nicely for tonight's championship game.
Yeah, then
there's a cool Saturday evening here in Concord.
And there's overflow across the field. Usually they don't put anybody there because they got both teams there. They don't want the fans to harass the team.
There's a throw in.
There's Barrett Parks being knocked off the ball by Madden, but he's got it back.
There's Barrett. There's Armstrong near him.
he tried to do too much, but he did earn a foul by DeLaSalle. So they get a nice opportunity here to play it.
A free kick situation upcoming. Here comes Spencer Lewis, number four. So DeLaSalle looks like they're going to set up a wall in front of Spencer. Here's one. Kick left side. And this one is headed, and this will go out of bounds.
Again, they're looking for Tyler Westville. He was deep on the opposite side of the goal, but his head ball was just wide. Swiss setting the ball nice and slowly, giving his defense some time to get a breather here.
Little drum roll for him this time. Puts a nice leg into this one out toward midfield.
I wonder if Crazy George from the San Jose Earthquakes here with that drum roll.
Here's Briz working with it.
Sends it down to Barrett Parks.
Down to the far side. Barrett falls down, gets up, recovers, keeps the ball to himself, and then it's knocked out of bounds by DeLaSalle.
He's really working hard, but he has to look to be a little bit more unselfish and pass the ball off and look for space to create opportunities.
Another throw in down near the corner here. For the Mustangs, let's see if they can't get something going. It's headed away.
Again, headed. Lawler. Evan Armstrong sends it back to Zahner.
Here's Zahner. He's going to head it goalward. And then Swiss will make the easy catch. So some more chances down here for Monta Vista, but still can't get that really good shot on goal.
There's that big kick.
So set it down the other way. And now we have a foul.
Yeah, Devin Perez, he wasn't really trying to play the ball. He was just jumping up and... That's when a player's out of control, and he'll get called for a foul every time for that.
Free kick upcoming here for Monta Vista. So the Mustangs in desperate need of some scores here. Trailing 2-0.
It looks like Monta Vista made some alignment change. They were going 4-4-2 in the first half, but down by two goals. They're only keeping three guys back. Looks like they're going 3-4-3 right now, the three attackers.
There's one headed back toward midfield.
That's Lawler, he got it.
Devin Perez hits the deck.
Lewis got the ball back.
Here comes Spencer.
There's a nice pass to Britt.
Here's Briz, he's got it. Spencer was trying to center it.
And Westfield
tried to shoot. Now this was kicked in, blocked by his own man that time. Still Monta Vista keeping it inside, and there's a shot on goal, but handled nicely by Swiss, and doesn't allow the rebound that time, Coach, because if he did, had a red shirt bearing down on him, would have been a good chance for Monta Vista that time.
Yes, and that was a good quality shot by Evan Armstrong.
That was Briz who was bearing down on him. And really, Coach, if he doesn't collect this one right off the bat, Monta Vista is going to get a goal. Take another look at it there.
It was a good hard shot, but it's straight at the keeper. And Swiss will gobble those up all the time. There's Patrick Dolan to Scythe, and he clears it nicely. Nice one touch to Perez, and Fitzpatrick just missed it. There's Mike Madden just missing the touches.
Players collide, no foul call.
And there's Scytho, big clear. Armstrong tried to clear it in, but now there's Patrick Dolan. He's going to take it up.
There's Dolan dribbling in, and this one's booted back the other way. For a moment there, it looked like the Spartans were getting something going offensively. They send it back here. And here's Fry to boot it away for DeLaSalle. Get some token pressure right there, but... When Fry's got that open lane to kick the ball, I don't think you really want to get all that close.
No, he's got a great power on that.
In fact, when out of bounds on the far side.
In fact, when Clayton Valley played him one time, one player did get too close, and I had to sub him out because he lost his wind on that one.
Coach, you also coached B.J. Burns.
Yeah, I coached B.J. Burns when the club team, DBSC Crusaders, for like 3 years, and he was a great player then, and now he's with the Ballistic Soccer Club. There goes Dolan, Perez.
Trying the breakaway.
And there's a speedy Lewis.
And this is broken up by Spencer Lewis. And BJ just able to kick it away as Devin Perez was bearing down on him.
Alan Harkins clears it, but Barrett Parks gathers it in. Let's put it on the ground. Michael Madden. One
nice
flick.
Play. Here's Perez running with it. And Perez is going to be tripped and knocked down. And then the whistle's going to stop play here.
And they're going to call a penalty on that one. Inside the penalty box, that's a dangerous play.
And Perez really looked like he had a great chance before he was taken down. Take another look here.
Here
what
it
a
is.
Job by Fitzpatrick to get him the ball.
Perez was going in, but Dalton had no chance at it and tried to bump him off the play, but the referees called him for obstruction. That's a penalty kick. Looks like Nick Scytho is up there. Again, Perez is going in, and Dalton just came in from the other side, and he put his arm up like that. I think if he might have kept it in and go shoulder to shoulder, he would have got away with it. But with that arm going wide, it looks like he was pushing Devin Perez down.
So a golden opportunity here on the penalty kick.
I guess Monta Vista.
Looks like Nick Seifel is going to take this one.
Yeah, Nick Seifel takes
it. Kick, and he scores!
Great shot, upper left-hand corner. He had no chance, PJ.
So tough to stop those penalty kicks, and Seifel here makes it what could be an insurmountable three-goal lead here for De La Salle.
Wow, in the first half, we had 41 minutes of play and one goal. Here, we only got into 16 minutes. Already, we've seen two by De La Salle.
You know, Roth, Fitzpatrick, and then Seifel here on the penalty kick, and take another look.
Here it is, upper left-hand corner. Very tough for any keeper to save.
And you saw BJ kind of sliding down as he was moving to his right and clearly had no chance to pick off that one. It's 3-0 De La Salle. And coach, right now, again, the Spartans starting to dominate this game.
Here it is, Seifel again. BJ makes the guess, went the right way, but it was going up high, not low.
And that situation, I mean, Coach, how often does a goalie actually stop one of those? Not very often.
Not very often, especially the level of skill that these players have out here.
All right, so Monta Vista really in the suit now. They need scores, they need them in a hurry. Bodies collide, on the ground they go, and they're going to call a foul against Monta Vista.
Yeah, I think you're going to see a little frustration now, Monta Vista. They thought they played very well in the first half. Now they're down by two goals, and it's going to be hard to get back in this game. And it doesn't look like De La Salle's taking the pedal off the metal, man. They're going straight at it.
Great Seifel. Ball.
Armstrong nice able to knock this one away. Beautifully done coming out of the goal that time.
That was a great ball in a dangerous situation, and BJ was strong coming out on it and clearing it away.
Had both hands up to knock that one away and at least for the moment prevent a four-goal De La Salle lead. But as we saw in the game against Amador, as the game went on and progressed, De La Salle's dominance kind of grew and grew the yeah. later we got into that game.
That's one thing about De La Salle is their commitment to fitness. Teams can hang with them for a half, but it's just that extra effort that De La Salle does in their training program that makes them really prepared for a full 80 minutes of play.
Well, they certainly have played better here as the second half has started, a one-goal lead at the end of one half of play. They've added two goals here. 3-0 Spartans as they get set to toss it in again.
Sean Talibas' throw. There's Dolan going for the head ball, but Westfield was there to clear it. Alex Harkin gets the ball up. Lewis
dangerous looking play there. Chase down to the side. Armstrong giving chase for Monta Vista.
It's
sent back in and now popped up into the air. Dolan going for it. He knocks it back the other way. And this one sent back the other side. Back and forth we go. Armstrong with a nice kick into it.
There's Michael Madden controlling it. There's Patrick Dolan. Alex Harkin with the ball. Again, the Madden. Oh, but he tried to flick it too much. That's Kyle Rowe.
And now down here on the near side of the field. Good camera work there as you take a look.
Monta Vista is still trying to keep it wide where they've been successful getting the ball down the field. But they got to get it in the middle to get some good scoring opportunities.
Still plenty of time to go. But a big lead here for the Spartans.
Swinging it well.
Rocco's Ristorati and Pizzeria, voted best pizza in the East Bay. Ignacio Valley Road at Oak Grove. Here's De La Salle again on the attack, but thwarted this time by Monta Vista. Sent over here to the far side of the field as they battle for it there. And out of bounds. Red shirts are pointing their way, white shirts are pointing their way, and the officials say a throw-in upcoming here for the Mustangs.
We got a substitute here, it looks like. Jeff Bitz is coming in. And Morgan Oliver Allen was out.
Nearly halfway through this second half.
There's Scytho clearing it up to Dolan, who swings it back to Alex Harkin. He just mishit it.
Booted into the stands.
And here's Andrew Zahner again with the throw in.
Thirteen shutouts on the year, as we said earlier, for Monta Vista. They've been shut out only once themselves. And right now being shut out by De La Salle.
Yeah, it's going to be tough to score on Swiss. Again, De La Salle only had 11 goals all year.
The defense for De La Salle has been very good, and they've turned up the offense here lately.
There's a big throw in the middle.
This one is going to be up and over the crossbar and out of bounds. And now here comes Stephon Fry to kick it away.
It's going to be tough for Monta Vista to get in, and De La Salle is going to be subbing players in and out. They're going to keep players fresh now with a three-goal lead. They'll keep players coming in and out and keeping the pressure on Monta Vista, so they'll be looking for the quickness and speed and not giving in anything to Monta Vista. Dolan up for the head ball, and Tyler Westfall challenged them. There's Kyle. He had a little bit of trouble. Barrett Parks gets it. He sends it up wide.
Mark
for Lewis.
Looking to get it into Lewis, but that one's headed back the other way.
There's Josh Terwilliger trying to clear it, but Lewis again with his speed over to Armstrong, looking wide.
So kick down, down into the corner. And that one will go out of bounds.
Looks like there was a foul down there.
We've got a very tough angle.
Yeah, with the stand so close, you can hardly see the end of the field.
Coach Kaleo and I are really trying to look out there and see what's going on. And now we've got an injured De La Salle player on the ground.
That's Alex Arkins, the outside fullback. It looks like Lewis just knocked him off the ball.
So hopefully Harkins will be all right.
Yeah. Again, De La Salle's up 3-0 with only 18 minutes left in the game.
Well, they'll certainly add a little bit of time, but for Monta Vista, they need goals in a hurry here. This one kicked out of bounds, a throw-in upcoming on the near side for the Spartans. Dolan's Lumber, Doors and Windows, 2750 Camino Diablo in Walnut Creek, 2231 Monument Boulevard in Concord. Here's one down into the corner, and that one is knocked over the end line.
And that's another corner kick for De La Salle. They're fourth of the game.
So a dangerous spot here again for Monta Vista. De La Salle, corner kick. This one sent a little bit too far.
Sent wide. Evan Armstrong gets the ball.
And Armstrong will kick this one back toward midfield.
Four whites on one red. That's not going to go through very well, those long balls. They're going to have to build it up through the middle because De La Salle is going to play back. As you can see, they got lots of numbers behind the ball. So Monta Vista is going to have to build it up with quick passes through the middle if they're going to get any scoring opportunities.
Here's one sent toward the far side, down to the corner. See if Monta Vista can't get this one centered. It's kicked out of bounds.
Yeah, sending it down is okay, but De La Salle moved all nine into the middle of the field, so it'll be very tough for them to get a scoring.
De La Salle is so fast out of that corner. When that ball gets down there and Monta Vista has the chance, they've really got to be quick and get that ball centered.
And
as quick as possible because the defense is there to react. This was shot on goal. This one is knocked up and over the crossbar by Swiss. And that was one of his best saves of the night.
That surely was. And it was a good scoring opportunity for Monta Vista. Hopefully this will give them some life as they're in the first corner kick of the half.
So they'll still have another chance with the Mustangs.
Here's get the replay again.
These are their first corner kick. Take another look
left
at it here.
Left foot shot going high. Swiss touches up and over there.
And Coach, he nearly overran that ball, but was able to adjust himself and make the beautiful save. Out it comes here to the far side. Here's De La Salle trying to get it out of the zone.
Yeah, sometimes when the defense is back there, you can't get a great look at it, and it looked like Swiss misread a little bit, but he was able to recover and knock it over for a save.
So, Monta Vista, another opportunity gone awry. Chance to cut into that three-goal lead. And they continue to trail 3-0.
Zahner sends a long one up to Briss.
Briss handling, left foots this one. Headed away. Chase it down here into the corner, and that one will go out of bounds.
Looked like it was deflected off of a De La Salle. No, it's a De La Salle throw.
You know, Coach, we're Brentwood Dodge, Chrysler, and Jeep, 8085 Brentwood Boulevard in Brentwood, 634-9900. Velocity Sports Performance, 1505 Willow Pass Road in Concord, 363-0066.
You know, it's a great thing that these sponsors help put this game on, because it's always good to see a good soccer game as we're seeing tonight.
And it's just nice to see championship soccer. It's nice to see somebody that's going to claim the title here tonight. It looks like it will be the Spartans, but still some time left for Monta Vista.
Monta Vista still has a fight in it. They're not giving up, and that's a good sign of a good team. There goes Vincent Colvis.
Here's a breakaway here.
Tyler Westfield's there with him.
Colvis. Looks like a little bit of pushing. No foul call.
That's a nice defense there.
We'll set off of the back of Kyle Volt. That goes out of bounds. And sent down the sideline.
That's cleared by Chris Carroll.
Here, Volt and Barrett Park colliding that time.
Barrett Park still has the ball. Sends it down to Evan Armstrong. And Nick Seithel's there. He's shielding him off the ball. And there's a foul. That was Monta Vista's 11th foul of the game.
Taking a look at it here, Coach?
Yeah, Evan Armstrong was trying to make something happen, but Nick Seithel was guarding the ball quite well, and he just collided with the back, and he may have called for a foul all the time for that. Sometimes it's better to stay in control and try to pressure him in there instead of going over the back like that.
This was sent back the other way.
There's Chris Carroll again clearing it. And there's Vincent Colvis with it.
So there's a fancy dribbler trying to get away, but has it taken away here by Monta Vista.
Josh Tuller blocked that one. That's Lewis. Touched it up. Try to get it back. Barrett Park chests it. Vincent Colvis battling. That's Kyle Volt clearing it.
Headed back the other way by Zahner. We'll get another chance here.
Look how quickly De La Salle is clearing that ball. They're not giving Monta Vista much. And that's going to tire a team out, especially if they have to bring it back from long distances. Fritz down on the sideline again.
Frizz.
There's a good cross.
The field that time, but well wide and high, and that'll go out of bounds. And De La Salle will get a chance to boot this one away.
De La Salle is making Monta Vista.
Purchase your copy of this game, shipping courtesy of UPS included, $25. Give us a call, 933-6264.
De La Salle's going to make it tough on Monta Vista. They're going to keep clearing the ball, and you're going to have to work it up the field quite a bit to get it going.
So De La Salle certainly in a defensive mode here. You know that Monta Vista has a long way to go to come back.
Especially with only 12 minutes left in the game.
Here's Devin one taken Perez. Away. That's Perez Lewis. Takes it away from Perez that time. Here's one cross.
Trying to find Armstrong up top. He's a fast player.
And Perez was running up the sideline and kind of slowed up that time. I thought he was going to be out there to have a chance.
Alex Harkin kicked it out for danger, but it's deep in the De La Salle defensive end, so Andrew Zahner will come up and look to send that long throw in.
Here, take a look at the booth here. And that is the extra crowd that's been sent to the far side of the field, because the near side stands are all full. And just what a great turnout we've had for this championship game. Here's one set way over the crossbar and through the football uprights. And if only that was a field goal for Monta Vista, we'd be tied.
Yeah, that's right. The reason why we have the overflow tonight is because our side of the stands are filled. De La Salle has the teams on the other side, and they don't want the players to be distracted by the fans, so they usually have only one side of the field have the stands. But with tonight's championship game, they're letting them fill the overflow section.
Just a great turnout here this evening. Championship soccer here.
Probably a good number of the overall fans are from the girls' Monta Vista team, who are the 3A champions this year.
4-3 win over Foothill for the Lady Mustangs. And De La Salle trying to add another NCS championship to their resume.
That'll be De La Salle's sixth championship
89, 91, 96, 01, and 03. Trying to add 05 to that list. And they've absolutely dominated the BBAL over that span. They won in 89 and then 91 through 03 and then again here in 05. Taking the Bay Valley League title. So I'm sure a lot of the other teams get a little sick of Spartan success.
Yeah, but, you know, the teams in the BBL, they always look to try to play the best teams, and De La Salle's there, and they always get up for that game, no matter who they are. It's tough to win the BBAL, but it's always good to have a good showing against a number one team.
Here's one sent out of bounds. Briss made contact with it, knocking it into the stands, and a throw-in upcoming here for the Spartans. Clock shows 9:30 and counting down. They'll add a little bit of time as we get to 2 minutes. But I wouldn't suspect they'd add a whole lot of time.
Devin Perez flicked it on, then got it back.
Here's Perez working it down into the corner.
That's Michael Madden. He tried to cross it, but it's blocked.
Blocked by Monta Vista, and it goes out of bounds.
Yeah, that's Jeff Britz. He's been, that's Barrett Parks. He's been quite active today. Again, only 9 minutes left in the game. De La Salle up 3-0.
And really began to dominate this game late in that first half when Andrew Roth scored and Fitzpatrick early in this second half. And then on a penalty kick, Seifel scored that third goal for De La Salle. And that's where we stand. Here's one set ahead. Armstrong giving chase, but here comes Swiss out to collect it.
Well, that's our first offside call. Barrett Parks sent a great ball, but Evan Armstrong just a step ahead of the defense, so he's called offside, and that'll be a De La Salle kick.
So wouldn't you know it, the first breakaway they get, and it's illegal.
Yeah, but, you know, you have to take your chances this late in the game, and if they can get away with it, it could be a good scoring opportunity. You hope that maybe the referee will miss it. That's a great ball. BJ comes out and knocks it away.
BJ doing a good job coming out of the goal. Knock that one away.
There's Chris Carroll over to Talibas, and then send it all the way back to Swiss. They know he can handle it. There's a clearance. Patrick Dolan puts it down on the ground. Monta Vista gets back. There's Jeff Britz over to Barrett Parks. They gotta build it up quicker. De La Salle's getting numbers behind the ball. Look at that defense just settle in now.
You see the red shirts wait a little bit longer, then all of a sudden all the white shirts are back in position defensively. Britz sends it across. Barrett's got it. Fancy dribble, but has it kicked away.
There's Jeff Britz again. He's going to put it down
got
the line,
it.
Maybe.
Left
no,
it.
Into the middle.
One set, blocked by De La Salle, and then kicked away by the Spartans. And then, coach, just a great job defensively by De La Salle, not allowing the Mustangs to get a good shot at it this time.
Again, Monta Vista did a good job building up the play, but it has to be quicker before the De La Salle puts all those numbers behind the ball. They're really making a commitment right now, putting nine guys back there. There's a good ball, dangerous ball, but De La Salle gets it. Alex Harkin tries to clear it. Dangerous play.
Yeah, it kicked away by De La Salle. They battle for it near midfield, and the Mustangs able to keep it in the offensive end.
Barrett Park knocked off the ball by Patrick Dolan. Dolan be called for the foul for that time.
So a free kick upcoming here for Monta Vista. Tyler Westfall. Now he'll give way.
He's leaving it for Danny Dalton. Tyler's a big guy. He wants to send it up to him. There it is.
Swiss comes out, makes the catch in traffic that time.
That was very good of Swiss. He was calm, cool, collected there, gathering that one in. Devin Perez went for the ball, missed it. Zahner's putting pressure.
Here's Perez battling for it with Zahner. And this one kicked out of bounds, and it belongs to Monta Vista.
Well, the crowd wanted the other way, but I don't think they're going to get it. The referee's got this game. And it looks like we're going to have a goalkeeper change. We're going to bring in Matt Ells for Stephen Fry.
Stephen Fry getting a nice hand as he departs. Here comes Matt Ells. He'll take over in goal for the Spartans. And listen to that crowd.
Yeah, the crowd's giving him a big hand. This is Stephen's last game. He'll be going to Cal next year, so... Coach Bryan wanted to give him a good send-off, and the crowd responded quite nicely.
Ball sent in and back out again. Knocked out by the Spartans. Another throw in here for Monta Vista.
That was Travis Livingston throwing that in. Barrett Parks going to be challenged by Josh Terrell. He wins that one. And Nick Seithel's coming up, and he's clearing it again.
And this one will bounce and go into the stands. Throw in upcoming here.
Zahner again.
Zahner to do it. Tossing in. A lot of white shirts around that time. And this one sent out of bounds by Nick Seifel.
Looks like they're calling a foul on Evan Armstrong, so that's how we'll get the free kick.
Purchase your copy of this game. Shipping courtesy of UPS included, $25. Give us a call, 933-6264. So here's Matt Ells to boot it away.
He has a pretty good kick himself. Josh Tulliger heads it up. Tyler Westfield gets it.
Now, far side of the field.
That's Livingston battling Salazar.
And out of bounds to Monta Vista on the far side. Pair of goals here in this half for De La Salle. And they have a commanding 3-0 lead down to 4:20 and counting.
Yeah, and even though Monta Vista went on the attack in the beginning of the half, they really haven't got a good quality shot off. They got maybe one shot off that was quality, and that's, again, because De La Salle knows how to protect the leads. And they're just putting nine people behind the ball and making Monta Vista work really hard.
Yeah, Monta Vista certainly had more opportunities there in that first half. Would you like to see more soccer on the Comcast Game of the Week? If so, give us a call, 933-6264. And if enough of you call in, well, we'll put on more soccer next season for you.
I hope so. It's really a good atmosphere out here tonight, and I think everybody enjoys seeing the game on TV.
Well, I'll tell you, Coach, you look around here, and you see all these fans in attendance. But for whatever reason, soccer just hasn't translated well to American audiences as far as viewership is concerned.
Well, I think part of it is that the professional league had to really depend on aging foreigners. They're key players, but you really couldn't see them in their prime. But with today's media and the internet, a lot of players are getting to see top quality European play, Latin America play, and now with the success of the U.S. World Cup in 2002, the quarterfinals, and recognition of some of the U.S. professional players making it over in the European leagues, I think you'll see it changing because they'll be able to identify with the players, and that's the key. Identifying with the U.S.-born players, and you'll see attendance grow.
So you think there's good news upcoming then for the Major League Soccer?
Oh, I think so. You know, they added two new teams this year, Salt Lake City Real and the Chivas USA. And Chivas USA will play out of the L.A. area and to capitalize on the big Latino community. And both clubs are using the logos of professional teams, the Guadalajara Chivas and the Real Madrid. So the colors and logos, again, that association with top-notch teams around the globe, again, will add excitement to the league this year. So we're up to 12 teams in the MLS, and it'll be an exciting season.
The world's most popular sport starting to grow here in America, and certainly as far as the youth is concerned, I mean, I believe there's more kids playing soccer now than are playing baseball in the United States.
Yeah, I think, you know, the players like the movement. They like to keep active, and it's nonstop action out there at soccer. Oh, and there's a dangerous play.
Sent in, very hard shot that time.
There's Barrett Park.
One of us is trying to stay on the attack. But
Evan Armstrong leaves it. There's Britz again. He's got it wide. He's going to play with it. Looks, makes a cross.
And nobody but home that time. They'll give chase out of the corner, and that ball will go out of bounds.
Monta Vista is looking to do a score, so they're getting into the middle of the field instead of going wide.
So we've gotten down to the two-minute mark. Now they're going to add some time here. Shouldn't be a whole lot. Not too many stoppages here,
no,
Coach.
No, there's not.
So we are winding down to another NCS championship here for the De La Salle Spartans. And right now, Monta Vista trying to get on the board and at least prevent the shutout. From coming out, Devin Perez giving chase. Perez still on it. Going to give that one a good kick.
Yeah,
and Brizzle will knock this one out of bounds. Brizzle will throw in Perez.
Yeah,
getting down the near side.
Monta Vista is doing a good job tonight. Even though they're down 3-0, they're representing the EBL very, very nicely. And over the past... You know, out of the last 25 years, the EBL won 11 championships and the BBL 6. So you're looking at two quality teams from two quality leagues.
Now the waning moments here of this game. This one's sent way out of bounds that time. I believe that was Michael Madden, number 13, knocking that one out.
Michael Madden clearing it wide. They're not going to give anything to Monta Vista. They're going to make them work for everything tonight. I guess we'll get a little out of stoppage time as that ball went over the stands here.
Oh, stands that time. Out of bounds and then some. And you'll have to hunt down the ball here before we can start action again.
They're getting one from behind the goal there.
So it's been all De La Salle here. Monta Vista making their best showing in that first half. Here's a throw-in for the Mustangs. Headed away by De La Salle.
That's Chris Carroll clearing it. That's Alex Harkin and Mike Madden. And there's a foul.
And De La Salle will have it. After the whistle. And you take a look at this big crowd in attendance. Getting ready to cheer here for the champion Spartans as they get set here to claim the 2005 NCS Championship.
Nice kick by Matt Ellis and Devin Perez. There's Evan Armstrong. That's Andrew Salazar. There's Josh Twilliger.
Monta Vista trying to get something going here, but just going to set back into the stands.
We're now in a stoppage time. I got 41 minutes. So
Alex Harkin's giving that one a nice boot that time.
Sounds like the De La Salle fans are already celebrating here. Looks like the referees are conferring on some foul here.
Hear this very festive crowd here tonight. As the referees sort out what's going on here. The Mustangs getting set for a throw-in, and now they'll get one.
There's Evan Armstrong pushing it up for Lewis, but Alex Harkin's there to clear the way.
Jader heads this one back the other way. Headed backwards that time and then booted forward by De La Salle.
There's Dalton putting it down, but Michael Madden came up,
sends the ball with some numbers.
Evan Perez, he's onside.
Left side. And Perez kicks one toward the far side of the goal and just wide.
There was a great cross, a great dangerous play.
Looking for that far post, and Perez sent it just wide, but a near chance here.
Perez sends it across, and Patrick Salazar comes in. It's past BJ, and Patrick just missed it as it goes wide. Nice, dangerous play.
So Perez nearly had another goal. He had two in that last game against Amador. Nearly added one here.
And it looks like De La Salle is keeping, when they see they have an opportunity, they're looking for another goal. Oh, we're at 43 minutes. Referee's looking at his watch. This game's going to end pretty soon here.
So Monta Vista looks like they will fall to 18-6-3 overall. De La Salle will go to 23-2-2 and claim the 05 NCS title. Okay, two straight times in 03 and now here in 05, the Mustangs have gotten to this final game only to be thwarted by the Spartans. Here's one set high up in the air to the far side and out of bounds. There is the final, 3-0 in favor of the Spartans, and they are the 2005 NCS champions, and they are mobbing each other over there near the Mustang side of the field. And there it is, the 2005 North Coast Section champions, the De La Salle Spartans, a final score of 3-0. Andrew Roth scores that first one, Fitzpatrick, and then Seifel on the penalty kick, and that rounds out the scoring. And we have a nice little montage here to show you. Actually, we're going to have that montage right after this commercial break. Again, the Spartans win 3-0, and we'll be back right after this.
For decades.
performance. Velocity Sports Performance. Maximize your potential. We guarantee it.
And we are back at Concord. De La Salle, and there you see celebration. Monta Vista, some awards and congratulations. They come up short tonight to the Spartans, who claim the championship of the NCS by a final score of 3-0. We're going to try to round up some players of the game and have some interviews for you. But first, let's take a look at the game stats. And there you have it. Spartans 10 shots, the Mustangs 7, 4 corner kicks to 1, 15 Spartan fouls, 13 for the Mustangs. But really a situation, Coach, where as the game went on, again, just like the Amador contest that we had the other night, the Spartans got stronger and really started to dominate that game late.
Yeah, you know, it's hard to come back from a three-goal lead there. But Monta Vista did play a great game. They're really a winner. They're not a champion, but they're a winner tonight.
Here we take a look at Fred Wilson down there, middle of your screen there, the long jacket holding the pennant. And a very fine season for Monta Vista. They came up just a bit short. And I think we're going to get Stephen Fry up here as one of our players of the game.
Yeah, he did a really good job. You know, he settles down the defense and communicates with them. They're comfortable with passing the ball back to him. And he's sending those long kicks. Again, it's like having an 11th field player on the field when he sends that ball up.
Certainly covers a lot of ground, but that Spartan defense was wonderful. Here, look at Fitzpatrick, also had a couple of good games that we saw here on the Comcast Game of the Week.
Yeah, De La Salle had a balanced attack, as I see. They had three goal scorers tonight, Andrew Roth, Nick Fitzpatrick, and Nick Seichel.
Well, De La Salle accepting congratulations.
That's Patrick Dolan.
Some of their awards here. And yet another banner to hang on their wall. More skins on the wall for De La Salle. Their soccer team proving to be as tough a competitor as their football and basketball programs. And there you see it, the 2005 North Coast Section Champion, De La Salle Spartans.
And again, that's their sixth championship overall. So they'll be getting another star on their T-shirts. Right now they wear T-shirts with 5 stars. Yeah, every championship you get a star. So De La Salle's going to get new T-shirts this year. They'll have 6 stars on there, 1 for each championship. A great job tonight.
So Monta Vista was hoping to make it a clean varsity sweep as the girls beat Foothill 4-3 in overtime, but De La Salle claims the boys' championship. And there's the pennant being awarded
to Brian Baltitone. Great job.
Head coach of the Spartans. Another plaque to put on the wall. And there's the celebration for De La Salle, 2005 North Coast Section Champions.
Yeah, Brian will be congratulated on Monday night when the BBL coaches get together and vote for all league. And we're always proud that the BBL has a championship, so he'll be getting nice congratulations.
But honestly, wouldn't you like to see somebody else claim it?
You know, they're a good team. It's always good to have different teams playing. And it took De La Salle 2 years to get here, so... they've been giving everybody else a chance.
Let's go to that montage, and then following that, we'll have our players of the game. We'll be right back. And here we are with some of the players of the game. Let's first talk to Stephon Fry, the goalkeeper. And Stephon headed to Cal, and to another great performance here by De La Salle. You guys seem to wear everybody down. Like, same thing with Amador. The second half, you guys seem to take control. What separates you from the other good teams come late in the ballgame?
Just the way we prepare for the games, I think. Today, I think the hardest game was pretty much Wednesday. And we knew if we make it into the finals, it'd be over. It'd be our game. And today, before the game, we just came together, watched a movie at one of the players' house. We knew everybody was ready for that.
Now, Stephon, you had a really good game, but your defense obviously played really well. Not a whole lot of good shots on goal for their team. What can you say about your defensive performance tonight?
Defense is all, like, I mean, it's all the guys in front of me. If I don't have anything to do, then we don't get scored on, you know? So I can't really not complain. I mean, with Seifel in the back and my outside guys just doing a phenomenal job.
Tell me, what's the difference between the Swiss national team and local high school soccer?
It's been a long time since the national team, so I don't know. It's getting really more
competitive. Could they beat De La Salle?
I don't know. Right now, we're playing really good, so
good.
It'd be tough. Yeah.
A whole national team.
Yeah.
And thanks. Well, off to Cal next year.
Mm-hmm.
Good luck to you there. Let's bring in Andrew Roth, who scored the game-winning goal tonight. De La Salle only needed one goal to win. They ended up getting three. Andrew, tell us about that goal.
Cross came in, deflections, dropped right in front of me. I just slotted it away.
So 20 points for you tonight. It's kind of getting to be old hat. You're just scoring so much.
Yeah.
It's pretty easy for you?
You know, no. I got a great partner in the midfield with Josh Twilliger and Pat Dolan. And, you know, our team unity right now, no one can stop us.
What do you think about this club? I mean, you guys, it's almost as if we expect you to win.
Yeah.
So when you win, is it really, really exciting, or is it like, well, we're supposed to do this?
You know, we give our heart and soul in every game we play, every practice we play, every minute of the game. I mean, it's just, we deserved it. It was a great goal. Both the other goals were great. Spartans number one.
Spartans number one again, 2005 champions. Andrew, congratulations.
Hey, thanks a bunch.
Congratulations to the Spartans. Let's bring back in Chris Kaleo. Talk a little bit here about the ball game. Spartans doing it again. Here's Chris Kaleo joining us back in the booth. And Chris, well, another dominating performance for the Spartans.
Yeah, they really came out and played with a lot of energy tonight. And, you know, that's what...
Sorry about that.
That's what you expect from De La Salle. And they put on a great show tonight. And I think it all goes back to some of the coaching. It looks like Brian's coming in here, and it's probably have Brian talk about his club because he knows it better than I do.
Yeah, let's get a word here with head coach Brian Voltatorne, head coach of De La Salle, going to step in here, championship coach. And, coach, welcome. Congratulations on the NCS championship.
Thank you.
And tell us, how proud of you are you of the club tonight?
I'm extremely proud. I'm extremely happy for the senior class to go out with an NCS championship. It's something that the kids talked about at our dinner last night, that they wanted them to go out on top. Extremely close group of seniors, and all the underclassmen wanted it for them more than themselves.
Coach, if you had to point to one or two things, what is it that separates you guys from everybody else?
It's our defense. We have a lot of pride in the group that we have on the back line and our keepers in the net, and it showed again tonight, and we had our third shutout. And it's something they take a lot of pride in. They don't want to take a playoff. They're upset if they give up a goal, and it's just something that's really carried over for the whole season and even in the past couple of years. So,
you know, we think about it, something about endurance, the way that as the game goes on, you guys seem to get stronger. Why is your is it your endurance, maybe? What is it about that?
I don't know if it's endurance. I think we're blessed with some great athletes on this team that are naturally quick and fast. But if you ask them, they may say that I'm not the nicest coach in preseason because of the running we do. But they put a lot of work in, and they're extremely driven from the beginning of the season. So I give them the credit. They're putting the work in, not me.
Championship coach, thank you very much.
Thank you.
De La Salle, the 2005 NCS champions. And, Chris, you want to come back and say a final word here about this game? 2005 NCS champions, the De La Salle Spartans, and Chris Kaleo. And, Chris, thank you so much. And a final word, coach?
Well, again, De La Salle did a great job. Monta Vista was still a winner. They're not a champion. The champions are De La Salle Spartans, and it's a good show for the BVAL. And it was an entertaining game. And I look forward to the season starting up next year.
Well, for all of us here at Comcast, I'm Anthony Schultz for Chris Kaleo saying so long from Concord, where the De La Salle Spartans win the 2005 North Coast Section Champions. And so long, everybody, from Concord. And sponsoring us tonight on the Game of the Week, so many thanks to them. Rocco's Ristorante and Pizzeria, Velocity Sports Performance, and Dolan's Lumber Doors and Windows, Brentwood Dodge Chrysler Jeep. And thanks to all of our sponsors to help us bring to you the Comcast Game of the Week. From all of us here, good night, and so long from Concord.